Welcome back to Blackacre Ranch, guys. Today we're gonna have to focus on these beauties, all right? Overall health, making sure that they're taken care of. Some of these ladies are looking thinner than I like, and if you've been following the channel, that we've been worried about a little bit of parasite issues. We have not wormed them this year, this winter, because we never had it working for the squeeze chute. So we haven't wormed them. A few did, others didn't, but over this past week, some of these guys aren't looking too good still, right? It sounds like a broken record, but just some of them look a little bit thinner than I like. So we're gonna investigate that and the possible causes and see what we're gonna do to fix it. Okay, we got four bags. Now you guys know what this means. This means poo sample time, of course. Sharpie and some bags. We're gonna go ahead and give this to Charlotte. She can get two and I can get two. We're gonna try and just get some samples. Okay, now the babies, you know, the babies are the babies. They all got wormed. We worked them a couple episodes ago. If you haven't seen that, go check it out. And what really we're just gonna get is just to make sure that some of their samples are down. The first time we took poo samples, one came back and he was a little high for sure. And this is kind of just a verification to make sure what the worming that we did was effective. So we're just gonna get a number of samples to make sure that we are good. So I'm gonna put this in Charlotte's pocket.
I have a feeling you want me to participate.
You gonna grab some poo-poo?
Well, you didn't give me much choice, so I guess I'm gathering poo.
You don't need gloves for this, by the way.
I have gloves, I'm good. Okay. I'm gonna use the bag, though.
What's up, little people? We are here to sample from your rectum. Just little samples, guys.
From the ground.
It's always difficult to wait and wait. And wait. You think if we just run in there, we'd scare it out of them?
Yeah, I'm not sure that's the experience they need on their day today.
I think we sit in the truck. Just wait. Sometimes this takes a while. Be one with the buffalo.
Little baby buffalumps. Stood up. You freaked out 109. Now you just gotta make him poo. Baby.
Somehow I don't think that's a big enough sample.
Nice.
Let's go get some more. There's no sneaking up on them for sure with all these twigs. Now that I have a tainted bag, I don't think I can put this back in my pocket.
I think you're just ready. You're already ready already.
There, maybe I'll just fold it in and have a pocket.
You got some tails up. You gotta get over there.
All right, so we're gonna have to split up some duties here.
Duties.
Didn't mean to, but that was pretty sweet. Charlotte's gonna have to get the name or the number, and I'm gonna have to go find the poo because these guys are a little bit more scattery than the old bigger ones who just sit there and stare at you.
Is it 108?
108.
108. Yeah, 108 pooing.
It's so much harder when they've already been soiled.
She's still got her tail up. Well, I think they cleared the path for you to find the poo.
We are successful.
Got one.
I have to tell you, that poo was actually pleasantly plump. It was kind of nice. 108, right?
108. Now we go back on the hunt.
I'd like to get at least three.
Right, at least three.
So, back on the hunt. Ooh, another tail. It's better to wait in the car. These guys seem to be intestinally slow today. So we're gonna wait here. The beauty about being up here on this mountain, despite there always being wind, is the fact that the great thing is there's always wind. So right now it's a nice breeze, and every once in a while a cloud comes in and shades us. So we feel special as we wait for more poo.
That girl right there, she just gave us a sample. 106, Jeff's got it.
Warm.
Yeah, nice.
So we got one other one, but we're gonna spare you the crapshoot. It's not shooting a lot. So we've got three for the babies out of 13. That'll give us like a 1 to 4, 1 to 5. So we're gonna go over to the parents and kind of start doing the same thing. We'll catch you up over there.
We're getting ready. That's 5. And 6.
Whew. Look who ran up here and decided to join us, huh, Ahmed?
Oh, and here comes Bartok.
You got the next bag ready?
Yep.
All right, let's go. The reason we're out here doing this with these guys is we did just check about 5 of them about a month ago, and they all were fine. But over the last week, once we sent them over to 7 and they were there for an entire week, and they came back this week, they just started kind of, some of them didn't look too good, and I'm kind of having a hard time understanding why, when we have hay that has about 10% protein, they'd be losing weight. And so my only theory is it could be two things. Parasites, maybe they've started developing them higher and higher, and maybe that's an issue. Or buffalo like to graze. And if they have a preference, they'll graze before they eat just the stored up hay. So the grass just may not be very good at all. And so when they eat all this grass, they're not getting anything out of it. And so after they spend a week over there, they just kind of look a little worse for wear. And it could just be that. So we're trying to get our hay, or our grass, of course, better this year. But until then, we're just going to have to really work this hay and supplement as much as we can. I don't like supplementing, but you got to do it if you got to do it. So right now we're trying to rule out one of the two possibilities. Right now we want to find out, is there a parasite problem? We're going to try and get different animals than we had last time. And then two, we're going to have to figure out kind of a forage sample of our grasses. So let's get some poo. And this is going to be waiting, because even if they did poo, I'm not going out there right now. I don't know, that's gonna take some balls, man. I don't know.
Doggies, hi Darcy, hi boy. Hi, Missy. Hi Missy, where's Missy? There she is. Get down, boy, get down. Hi Missy. Oh, you little Lizzie girl. Hi. Get up. Where are you going? Hi. Hi. Kidding.
All right, so we've got, was it 4 samples now? 5? Something like that. There's certain ones that we were looking for. Number 14, 8, 33, B9, 13, 17, and 98. Those are ones that we kind of thought looked a little bad. Some of them actually are looking better right now, but we've got a couple samples from ones that we did last time. Really, we're just taking whoever's pooping right now, so it's not like it's, let's be selective here, right guys? But there are a few that we're looking for.
Someone's pooing.
Let's go find it. Find it. Ooh.
Here.
I feel like the crocodile hunter.
I'm gonna watch her. You go get the poo.
Right next to Ahmed.
Oh, come on. Pick up the poo in front of the big bull. Hey, Ahmed. Don't mind him. He's just gonna pick up some poo, okay?
That's some poo, dude.
Don't die, honey.
just want some poo.
You know, if you shoot him away, he'd get up. Maybe.
Jeez.
He's like, you guys are desperate, man.
Way desperate, man. Hey, it's a unique number. We're gonna take it when we got it. He didn't even care.
He did not care.
132. So wherever we left off, I have no idea. But obviously we're not picky, but we are desperate. Ahmed, man. Oh, there's another boo! Oh, I gotta get her. Hold on.
Go get her. Number six. Oh, go get her. Anything clean to rub that hand on in here.
Ultimately, there's certain ones I'm really wanting to get, and they're not the ones that are pooing. So I keep holding out and getting as many as I can, I guess, but I don't know, just never the ones you always want, right?
Yep.
We've been waiting for poo for 4 hours from animals, I swear. Anyway, yes, the patience finally paid off. We got number 98, so she was one that we were worried about. So we got her poo sample and like 8 others. We started denying people poo. Anyway, we got those now. Let's get some forage samples and we're gonna go out to pastures 4 and 5. So the second area that we were concerned with possibility for why they're looking thin would be the forage, okay? Now we already took care of poo samples in case it's parasites, but also when we first got these buffalo over a year ago, I tracked how much they were eating and then once we let them out of that small confined pen where there was really only hay, I analyzed it compared to how much their feed consumption for hay was at that point, and it was coming out to being like 50%, 50 to 60% drop. So in other words, they were getting off the grasses in the field about half of their hay or their feed intake or more, and the hay was only half. So when I'm moving these animals from pasture to pasture, they're gonna eat the grass. And if what I'm seeing from last week when I moved them back from 7, that they kind of just started taking a dive, is if they're eating this grass, whatever it is, and they're not getting nearly enough nutrients out of it, then I'm gonna keep seeing a decline in their, what do you call it, their conformation, their health, their look, whatever they've got, you know, however they look, there's gonna be a decline. So like we did with the hay, we sent it off for a forage sample. I'm going to take a sample of here, and I'm going to see just kind of what's in it. You know, it could be super bad, it could be super good. Pasture 6 and 7, of course, are super thin. So I'm not going to take it from there, but we're going to be building out in pasture 5 right here, and in 4 down there, some pens, and I want to see kind of what they got. So this is going to be my representative sample of kind of what generally it is. And this is just a random spot, 2x2. I'm just going to snip it with these guys and load it up in a bag and see kind of what nutrients we got. Really?
I feel like there's nothing here.
There's not much here. We should have gotten that grass over there.
We can walk over and get more.
This is just one sample. We just start grabbing anything that was green that would have some life in it because we have a lot of sticky stuff. sticks. So, anyway, we'll see. We're gonna get more samples. Okay, this looks a little bit more hopeful for what we're wanting. Obviously, it's not fully representative of the pasture. I don't think I need those.
No, unfortunately, I don't think they do enough good.
We're acting like buffalo, just eating. All right, we're gonna get one more from four. So we're gonna go back up on the top side near Pen C and just go up over there. It's more sandy up there, but we're gonna see kind of what we got. All right, so we got our three across the board. We tried not to be too picky, but we're gonna send these off to see what forage results we get. We know we're gonna have to plant. I just wanna know how bad we really are right now, because that could help give us some understanding as to why the buffalo seem to look worse at times. And it just doesn't make sense. So anyway, let's get these things gone. You guys are all free to eat. Keep munching. Doing as you please. Yes, you can eat too. You can go back in. It's been a great day. You guys like your new home, huh? Yes, you can eat. There you go. Have a friend. I know. Next time, we're gonna put numbers on both sides of the tag. Like most people, we're not any different, guys. Most ranchers I know care for their animals, and they want them to do well. We want to see them looking great, and that's what we're trying to do today. We're trying to find the cause of why we keep seeing a downturn in the animals and bouncing back up. So we've got a lot going on here. We've got to get pastures up and running. We've got to get facilities up so we can worm the animals. We can work them, we can weigh them, we can monitor them. It's just taking time, and we're trying to keep the animals looking good while we're doing that, to give them the best shot possible. All right. So anyway, future stuff is coming, still seeding. We got to seed all these pastures. We're in talks with people about seed. We just got to wait for it. That guy still looks at me. Even pastures for him. So we're going to get some seed. And number 105 peeks around. Even for these little guys. Guys, we appreciate you joining along, guys. We're going to wrap it up here. Catch you next time. Like and subscribe the video. And subscribe to the channel. We'd love to have you back. Talk to you later. Bye.